Hi guys, my name is Gert Blom. I'm working for the city of Helmond, a small city in the south of Netherlands. Welcome to this course about intelligent transport systems, ITS. This is my expertise. I'm working since 15 years for the city of Helmond. I have a background in private companies, but now I'm working for the city of Helmond. In the domain of smart mobility, I'm a strategic advisor mobility, but especially in the field of ITS. And I think there's a good challenge for you to apply ITS for mobility solutions. And this is what I hope you get out of this course. ITS and traffic management are closely related, and ITS is also a very good means to reach your policy goals. But I would like to start with a kind of disclaimer. ITS is not the solution for all your mobility challenges. ITS could be part of the solutions to your mobility challenge, but ITS, in my opinion, is a very good tool to get from your policy goals towards really implementation of your policy goals. For example, giving priority to certain user groups like public transport or trucks in your city. That's a very helpful tool. But in general, for me, ITS, it's about two fields. It's about increasing efficiency of your urban traffic network, and it's about increasing road safety in your city. If you look into practical examples of ITS, what ITS could do, I think there are two main fields of applications. One is to get your traffic system, to get your traffic more efficient, to increase traffic capacity, to reduce the traffic congestion. And the other application field domain is about increasing road safety, for example, ISA. And the first one is giving priority to certain group of users, for example, give priority to public transport. As a city, as local authorities, we're always looking for new solutions for our traffic challenges, I would say. This could be, of course, in the past it would be a new infrastructure, new roads, building new roads, but every city is now looking for other solutions, like increasing the capacity of existing infrastructure. And we could very much look to the industry to deliver us ITS solutions. And it's a bit changing the roles between public and private, of course, and this will be the new future. But in fact, we are a city, we're looking for new technologies, new solutions to increase our road capacity and, of course, to increase road safety. A very practical example of applying ITS in our city, in the city of Helmond, was about communication from truck drivers with traffic controllers. And this was because our main problem in our city is a lot of heavy goods vehicles going through our city, and of course a lot of stops, a lot of emissions, a lot of noise in our city. And in this way we looked for an ITS solution, a technology-driven solution, and we found it in communications between an onboard unit we installed in trucks, communicating with the traffic lights. And the solution was, in fact, it was communicating, giving a speed advice to the truck driver, giving a time to green advice to the truck driver, but also giving us a level of priority for the truck drivers at the intersection. The result was quite impressive because we had 13% fuel savings for the truck driver, so there's a business case for the transport company, but also 13% less CO2 emission, and of course increasing capacity of our roads because the number of stops and the number of congestion really went down dramatically. When you're talking about ITS, it's not only about communication of vehicles with traffic controllers, it's also about informing the users. A very good example, I think, is informing the car drivers about the parking spot availability in the city. A lot of traffic in your city, I think it applies to every city, it's search traffic. People looking for a parking spot. And with what we've done now in the city of Helmond is just an example where we have smart cameras really detecting free spots of parking spots on an individual level, sending this through a back office to your smartphone and immediately guiding you to the next available free parking spot. And this really helps us to reduce search traffic in our city. When you look at the trends in ITS, there are a lot of trends, but one is very obvious. It's the moving towards a lot of data, and the big data is coming also in the field of ITS, of course. There are so many sources of data available, from private sources, from public sources. So this is really a trend, and we have to cope with it, because every car is delivering a lot of information, a lot of data, and we could make use of it, of course. A second trend, well, everybody knows it's a trend towards automation, road automation. Coming from connected cars, cooperative cars, really going to automated cars, automated vehicles, and it will really change the field of transport, of mobility, but also spatial planning. A third trend, I would say, is the trend from information from roadside towards in-vehicle information on an individual level. A fourth trend, what we think is very important as a city, is going away from these local pilots, but really going to large-scale deployments, to upscaling, to economies of scale. It's not about doing local pilots, but it's really about deployment, large-scale deployment. It will always be public authorities on a national level, on a local level, who will do the framework, the policy framework, but it will be more and more private companies who will deliver information, who will use the information, who will send the information to the users. And in the end, it's all about getting satisfied users, getting satisfied citizens. And another thing we learned in Helmond, it's not only happening in megacities about ITS, also smaller cities and medium-sized cities can have a very positive role in research on ITS, in deploying ITS, and really using ITS. Yes, my friends, if I may give you one last lesson, it's a really practical lesson, but come out of your office, please. If you're doing projects on ITS, it's not happening on the round tables, on all the in the offices, but come out of your office and speak with your transport companies in your city, with your local stakeholders, with your European stakeholders, with public transport companies, with all the users, of course. This is very important. It's ITS deployment is not happening in the office, it's happening on the street. Well, thank you very much to have participated in this e-course. I hope I have inspired you a bit to look in the possibilities of ITS technology as a tool for your city to achieve your policy goals in your city. Thank you very much.